Sponsored by the Big 98, Nashville's number one for new country and the home of the Bobby Bones Show.
We're so honored to have back on the show country music legends, two of the Oak Ridge Boys. We have William Lee Golden, Richard Sturban. Gentlemen, thanks for coming on the show.
Man, it's so good to be with you here.
You know, I feel like I keep up with you guys,
yeah.
You know, all the time, just from everything you have going on social media. And I've got to bring up this Tennessee Pathways marker now for the Oak Ridge Boys.
That was last week.
Yeah.
They unveiled that. We were up in Oak Ridge, Tennessee when they unveiled it. So that was a cool thing.
Just amazing. Well, and I, you know, I hate to be the bearer of bad news here, because when I heard it through the press, I couldn't believe it. But just wrapping up your Front Porch Pickin' Tour, sold out all over the country. I got to see you year before last at your Country Music Christmas at the Grand Ole Opry, which was amazing. I'm hoping they do it again. Now, American Made 50th Anniversary Farewell Tour. How did this happen?
Well, it's just the years kind of caught up with us, I guess.
Like the awards, right?
Yeah,
you know, you get all these awards and now 50 years sneak up on you.
Get out there busy, and we've been doing like 150 days a year on the road, man. And
right.
You kind of forget how long it's been, and then all at once you realize it's been 50 years, and where did it all go?
And you got, but it doesn't seem it, because I mean, certainly, you know, and I got to brag on you guys because you won't. But with 17 number one hits and I believe 27 in the top 20 on the charts, I mean, the Oak Ridge Boys, all of us have grown up with you guys, you know, and know all the songs. I was telling you about the last time I came to a show and I was in line, you know, to come see you guys play, which I always enjoy. And it was like people with their entire families. It wasn't like a person or a couple. It was like 4, 6, 8 people, multi-generational, coming to see the Oak Ridge Boys.
Right.
And so people, you know, when they come there and they're singing the songs with you and just cheering you on, I mean, it's still, even though 50 years in, what a great experience, right, Richard?
There's no question about it. And you know, we would not be who we are today without those fans of
right.
ours. They're very special to us. And I think that's one of the reasons we want to do this farewell tour. Mm-hmm. So we can go around the country and tell our fans thank you
right.
for allowing us to have such a great career. You know, and we've experienced a great life. It would not have happened without our fans.
So that's
the main reason for this farewell tour.
Right, Richard, but it may have to go international. I mean, this may be a multi-year farewell, still farewell, we're still saying goodbye, because I got a feeling that people are going to have to get their tickets early for all of these shows. Plus, we were talking, I mean, hopefully not out of school, but there's rumors about, you know, an album with David Cobb possibly coming out in January and possibly another 50th anniversary American-made album coming out. I was thinking what would be a blast, particularly with the wealth of songs that the Oak Ridge Boys have, is having other artists even join in the Oak Ridge Boys. And then you guys still have to do your rock album. Dolly just did a rock album.
Well, let's do it.
Well, you know, I think one of the things I've always loved about you guys, too, and your voices and just how much charisma you bring, you guys are entertainers, really. And but with the gospel music, you know, and certainly how the band started. But it's still, when you guys get into the gospel songs, they just feel so heartfelt.
Yeah. Well, it's where we're, it's our roots, I guess. You mm-hmm. know, we all grew up in churches and singing gospel songs, and the first few years we were together, we were basically a gospel group.
Right.
And then our music started expanding, and we got with Jim Halsey Company, who was a top manager and agent, and we're still with Jim Halsey, but he was able to take the Oak Ridge Boys, get us with MCA Records, and
right.
Also get exposure. He had an LA office, and had someone that concentrated on network television out in LA, and so they was able to get the Oak Ridge Boys on Tonight Show and a lot of different specials, you know, and the big award shows. And so it's our music, thankfully, is kind of, like you said, it's kind of gone over generation to generation.
Right.
And we still have that at our shows. We'll have young people coming out there and be everywhere out there, and you ask them, you know, how'd you hear the Oak Ridge Boys music? Because our heyday was back before they were born, a lot of them. And then they talk about it was their grandparents, at their grandparents' home or something. And they're gone, and they wanted to come feel closer to them through the music. It's a connection like that of passed down, and people come and remember the ones that's gone on at our shows, and that they, it kind of takes them back to those peaceful time.
Yeah. Well, and I think, and the music too. I mean, you know, the Oak Ridge Boys harmonies, you know, the vocal quality that each of you bring as individuals, but when you put all four of you together, and certainly with your team also, I mean, you've got team members with the Oak Ridge Boys that have been with you for 50 years.
Yeah.
Kind of unheard of in this day and age. Everything's a little more transient and people move around, but to have a legacy like that, and I got to ask you this, Richard, obviously, because I remember with the front porch picking, you know, the front porch singing to where the whole bus had to be wrapped. Is there going to be a new bus wrap?
Well, we don't know. At this point, anything is possible. Mm-hmm. One, you know, we talked about this before we started the interview. We've announced our farewell tour.
Right.
But we have not announced when it will end. We don't know that. You know, we have to be realistic. We know that everything must end, including us, and that end is closer than it used to be.
Right.
But we're going to be around for a while because we want to take time, as I said a few minutes ago, to thank our fans for allowing us to have such a great career, because we would not be who we are without those fans.
Well, and also, Richard, don't you think that's why you guys constantly have sold-out shows? Because when with Front Porch Singing, also, huge success, you know, with radio play, you know, on the digital formats, everything else. So, you know, it's tough when you have that many great songs and you have to do so many of the hits. I mean, you can't leave the stage without Elvira.
Yeah.
I mean, there's so many hit songs that you guys have to where it's like, okay, going in, I have to hear this. But then you want to put in the new songs too, right?
We do, you know, and we, that's the thing about working with Dave Cobb. There's always great young writers that he pulls songs from, and then he also loves to go back into retro old songs and mm-hmm. put a new twist to it and simplify some of them, and you know, and then do it in harmonies. And
right.
So we've enjoyed that with him, is not only new stuff, but singing, reviving older songs mm-hmm. and enjoying them.
Well, and obviously Dave, you know, can choose who he works with and enjoys working with the Oak Ridge Boys, and just a musical genius. I mean, we're so fortunate to have Dave here in Nashville. And once again, you know, your last album, you know, the music that you've done with Dave Cobb just sounds incredible. The mixes, you know, it's still got your four voices, but it's just, and always your band is always amazing too, but they sound great. I mean, they sound fresh and new, and that's what Dave is able to bring with you guys.
Well, he's a genius in a lot of ways, and we have to give him a lot of credit. It was his idea for us to do the Front Porch Singing album. He called us, you know, it was during the pandemic, actually, and everything was closed down here in Nashville, including the recording studios. But he called and said, fellas, we can now record. We just have to be careful, abide right. by the protocols and, you know, social distancing and all mm-hmm. that. He said, but what I want to do is to capture the feeling
right.
of four guys just kind of gathering on a front porch and just in a very informal way, mm-hmm. just kind of harmonizing together. And as William said earlier, Dave Cobb is a master at capturing feelings mm-hmm. like that. He can do it like no one else. And he was able to do that with the Oak Ridge Boys. You know, he actually originally got the idea when he came to see our Christmas show. You talked about right. it yourself. We had a section where we sit in rocking chairs in front of the fireplace.
So
and
awesome.
He was so impressed with that down-home feel that he wanted to capture that feeling mm-hmm. and put it on a record. And he was able to do that.
You know, and once again, it gives me goosebumps talking about that, Richard, to where, you know, when you guys were sitting there in the rocking chairs and we're talking about, you know, joking about the bus wrap and all. But for me, it felt like when I was younger and all the family members would get together and play and sing on the porch with the music. And it's just, it harkens back to a time that I think people miss, kind of like you were saying, William, yeah. to where, you know, people like those memories and of our family members that are maybe not with us anymore. But the great music that you guys have generated over these decades, you know, still able to bring this up. And with all four of you sitting there in rocking chairs and just singing and bringing great music, it was special.
Yeah, it was a section in the where we'd do that, you know, and each guy would kind of talk about Christmas and where they're coming from. Mm-hmm. And then that person would sing lead on a song in the set, and but each guy would get a chance to talk and choose a song to sing it while we're sitting there, and then we harmonize with it. So it was a very relaxed and a down-home feeling.
It felt intimate, William. You know, being there at the show as I was, and even though the entire room was sold out, I mean, you know, standing room only, but it's like going, it just felt so personal to where each of you were sharing a personal, deep story. I've got to ask you this question. With the American Made Farewell 50th Anniversary Tour, might there be special guests, depending on the cities where you play or countries, that may join the Oak Ridge Boys on stage?
That sounds like a great idea. William Morris Agency, William Morris Endeavor, they're the ones that booked the Oak Ridge Boys, mm-hmm. and it's just, it was 6 weeks ago that we had the meeting, and when it was all decided that we would try to do that, we would agree to do that next year. So they've just started in the past month booking, choosing the dates that we will be traveling to throughout the country for next year.
Wow. And one of the biggest agencies in the world. You know, I was going to bring up also, William, you know, with you and Richard and with all the Oak Ridge Boys, knowing you guys, you know, like I do, and having the great opportunity to interview you over the years, and I think what would be fun to see is kind of, you know, the Oak Ridge Boys through the years. You know, just like, you know, when you guys, you know, first started with the band and through the years with everything and all the different hairstyles that Joe had. Also, the different mustaches that Joe had. You could do like a whole thing on that. You could actually have social media just for like Joe's mustache or hairstyles.
Go back to when before I lost my razor.
I've seen pictures, William. Yeah. I've seen pictures, you know, and I mean, but what fun to be able to, you know, for fans to be able to see that and be a part of that. Of the history, because I mean, your music is part of our lives, but then also those images, you know, whether it be within, you know, a book form or on screen. I mean, it's just, you know, we've all kind of grown up with you guys.
It takes us back at night when we're singing those songs. It does me, you know. You trip back to when it was a new song and when it was you get into it, the feeling of the happiness when you were actually recording the song mm-hmm. sometimes. So but that's good. It's when songs affect us the way they do, and right. then you're able to share your feelings through harmonizing with the other guys, and it's a beautiful thing.
Well, you know, and I've got to bring this up too. I noticed to where in the past year or so, it seems like everybody from every genre of music and everything else has been coming to the Oak Ridge Boys and going, hey, can you be on our album? Because I'm like, it seems like every press release and post I get, like every other one's like, oh, and the Oak Ridge Boys are on this song. I'm like, when do they sleep?
Well, we stay active, you know. I mean, we're out there, like I said, we've been doing 150 days on the road.
Right.
This year we're doing like 110 or 12.
That's not much of a cutback.
And next year we kind of want to cut it back further, so probably 50 or 75 dates we might book.
Unless you got a good residency. Then you might, you know, yeah, I'm just hypothetically, it could happen, William Lee. I mean, you know, if you were doing something locally to where you could perform here in Nashville and then go home to your own bed.
Hey, we did that for, what, three different Christmas tours
right.
here with
Sold
Nashville.
Out. Sold out Christmas
yeah,
tours.
That was a lot of fun.
I'm just putting that out in the air. I think it'd be a great idea.
I'd love to, man. We get to spend the day at home with the family and mm-hmm. then go out to the Grand Ole Opry House and out to Opryland Hotel
right.
where the party's really going on
mm-hmm.
and get out there and sing some Christmas songs with people that's come to town.
You know, I enjoyed one of the other shows that I really enjoyed seeing you guys at was at the CMA Theater, you know, at the Country Music Hall of Fame. You know, and it's like, once again, it's just full of energy. It's like one of those shows where I didn't feel like I could miss it. And it was like all industry people and everybody's there just singing along with you guys.
Yeah.
And it's like, well, you know what? I'm glad it's not going to end abruptly with the 50th anniversary tour, but an American Made Farewell Tour,
yeah.
You know, kicking off.
Yeah, and it'll be a sad time, you know. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of reflection going on here
right.
and a lot of great memories. And like you say, there's families that have brought their kids have grown up with us. And. Mm-hmm. Then they're bringing friends of theirs, but we have a lot of different families that were young families that now then their kids have grown up, and
right.
Some of them are having kids, so it's I don't know, man. It's just amazing how in a lot of situations that we have so many generations of people coming to this.
It's just incredible. Yeah. And also from the different styles, from back to the gospel music and obviously with all the hit country music.
Yeah.
It's just, I mean, amazing. What an amazing body of work. And I mean, I'm thinking too, I wouldn't mind seeing a documentary on you guys. Maybe we need to call Ken Burns.
Where's Ken Burns?
Where's Ken? You know, I think we could probably reach out to him and go, hey, yeah. I got an idea, Ken.
Hey, that sounds good.
I think I'd watch it multiple times on the Oak Ridge Boys.
Great thought.
I'm telling you. Well, and also, speaking of which, Richard, possible the new albums, you know, looking, you know, for the first one coming out maybe January or so with David Cobb.
Well, we actually have booked recording dates in January.
Ah.
The last part of January. So, the original discussions involved possibly having a release around Mother's Day, but we don't know that yet.
You
know,
right.
We're taking one day at a time.
That's why viewers need to go to your website and social media and check out all the vintage pictures.
Yeah.
but also for the to get their concert tickets early and to find out about the new album releases for the year, right?
That's correct. And we want people to come on out and celebrate together with us. You know, it's a sad thing in a lot of ways because we know the end is not that far away. Mm-hmm. But it's also a celebration at the same time. So it's a bittersweet feeling. We want people to come out, celebrate 50 plus years together with the Oak Ridge Boys because it has been a great thing. Mm-hmm. No question.
Totally. And so the website for the Oak Ridge Boys and social media and everything else, they just need to look up the Oak Ridge Boys, right?
That's it.
OakRidgeBoys.com.
There you go. Well, I'll tell you what, you definitely want to get your tickets early. This is, the 50th anniversary, the American-made farewell tour with the Oak Ridge Boys. Watch for the new music, but go see these guys live because there is nothing like it. If you love great four-part harmony, incredible music from country music to gospel, the Oak Ridge Boys always deliver. Thank you, gentlemen, for coming on the show.
Great to see you again.
Great to see you. I can't wait to see the concert.
Yeah.
I'll be coming to the concert, too, several.
Thank you.
Sponsored by the Big 98, Nashville's number one for new country and the home of a Bobby Bones Show.